Summer's a great time of year for berries, and what better way to take advantage of them than topping a pavlova? Now, I usually pass it up at a party because I find pavlovas, they're too creamy, they're too sweet, and usually too big. So I've come up with this pavlova roll version, and it actually takes a lot less time to cook. I've filled it with yogurt and mascarpone, so it cuts through the sweetness, and then I top it off with some berries, tossed in some balsamic vinegar and basil. It's really great. Okay, so you need the same things that you would need if you were making a traditional pavlova. So you need a lined tray and 6 egg whites, 200 grams of caster sugar and 2 teaspoons of corn flour and a pinch of salt and some cream of tartar and vanilla. So you'll need a mixer to make the pav. Now, one of the things that makes a meringue or a pavlova really successful is that you need scrupulously clean instruments. So your whisk and your bowl should have absolutely no oil on it whatsoever. And start off by separating 6 eggs. Oh, and also you should preheat your oven to 165 degrees. So now pop the bowl on the mixer and start mixing at a medium speed and turn it on at the power point. And add a teaspoon and a half of cream of tartar. Pinch of salt. And then turn up the speed a little and gradually rein in 250 grams of caster sugar. And do this gradually so that the egg whites can take on the sugar evenly. And once your egg whites are light and glossy, turn down the speed to really low and add a teaspoon and a half of corn flour and a teaspoon of vanilla. Turn off the machine and bang the meringue off the whisk. Oh, that's pretty glorious. And then pile the meringue onto the tray. So next, grab yourself a palette knife, and unlike a traditional pavlova, you're going to flatten it right out to a rectangle about 40 centimetres and about 35 centimetres wide. And it's important to get it as even as possible as well, because if you don't, the meringue will cook unevenly. It's a little bit like concreting. I love doing this stuff. It's fun. Okay, we're nearly there. Here's a little fiddly. And I'm just squaring up the edges too. Into the oven for 15 minutes. So while that's in the oven, we'll make the real star of the show. Grab yourself 2 punnets of fragrant strawberries and 2 punnets of raspberries. And you'll also need some basil, a little bit of sugar, vanilla bean, and some balsamic vinegar. So slice up the strawberries in some rounds, quite thick slices. And if some of the strawberries are quite small, just cut them in half, because it makes the salad look a little wild and natural. Not everything has to be cut the same way. Bang. And then topple in some raspberries. Be gentle with these guys, because they crush easily. Also need a fresh vanilla bean. Cut on the angle into fine splinters, and this just looks great amongst the berries. And then just sprinkle them in. Add a couple of teaspoons of sugar. And then add a couple of splashes of balsamic vinegar. Now, if it has a bit of age on it, it's a really good thing because the flavour is so beautiful. And add some basil. I like to pick off some of the smaller leaves, throw them in, and also add some of the larger leaves, just chopped lengthwise. This adds a lovely herbaceousness to the salad. It's quite unusual, but really works. And now just give them a little jiggle and set them aside. Have done. Beautiful. Now just let it cool for 5 minutes. For the filling, you'll need 250 grams of mascarpone cheese, and just mix that together with about 150 grams of sheep's milk yogurt. And I'm using sheep's milk yogurt because it has a really lovely sharpness to it, which works really well with the sweetness of the meringue. And just combine them. Grab yourself a clean tea towel, lay it out flat, and then dust it all over with icing sugar. I haven't lost the plot. We're not gonna eat the tea towel. Now grab your meringue and flip it onto the tea towel. Then gently pull back the paper. Do this slowly, you don't want any holes. Then smother it with your filling. And now with the help of the tea towel, roll it up. Just like that. And there you go. And now grab a platter and lift the roll gently and quickly on top. And now just spoon the berries over the top. And try and balance them on top as best you can. It's just fine if they fall down to the side. And if you have any juices left over, just pour them over the top before you serve. Oh, that looks good. And that's my take on the traditional Pavlova. Yum, yum.